Law and politics. Judge Henderson is on this case. She's a very conservative jurist. She voted against Donald Trump just as much as the other two judges. It reminds me of, like, you know, kind of those historic votes that have passed. I remember Jeffrey Sutton, who was up for, on the short list for the Supreme Court, very conservative judge, upholds President Obama's Affordable Care Act, the first judge to, you know, so-called cross party lines. This is what it's about. I mean, no presidential get-out-of-jail-free card in our Constitution. This is the essence of what American democracy is. And I do not think, and we can talk about this more later, I don't think the Supreme Court's going to touch this with a 10-foot pole.
Neil, talk about right now in terms of what do you think the elements of the opinion, which ones carry the strength that will make the Supreme Court feel the job's done, they don't need us?
I think the most important piece is constitutional structure, just that our entire system is basically a rebellion against King George III and the idea that people can be above the law in our system. There's lots of small points that are made. Some of them are really good, like, you know, Donald Trump himself said in his second impeachment, his lawyer said, you know, don't impeach him because he can be criminally prosecuted. And now he's turning around and saying, oh, I can't be criminally prosecuted because I was a former president. There's lots of small things like that. But to me, the ultimate thing is Donald Trump is citizen Trump. That's the way the opinion ends. And that's like a fundamental principle in our Anglo-American system of government. No person's above the law. Everyone is treated equally. It's what the words on the top of the Supreme Court say, equal protection under law. And that's what this decision is all about. It's why I don't think the Supreme Court will take this case.
Edward, I have to say, in reading it, there's a lot of things I didn't know. I didn't know about that congressman who said this 200 years ago. I didn't really know the Marbury versus Madison linkage to any of this. There it is. So there's a lot of illumination about historical detail, but there's not a single surprise. There's nothing surprising about it at all. This is the country I thought I was living in.
Yeah, so there's something incredibly affirming about this, but I think one of the reasons Neil and I and many others were not surprised by this is the